beer's in the cooler there.
Oh, yeah. I don't think I should drink a wheat beer. I'm not sure about it.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it really is.
What do we start with?
Banjo.
That's right, Mark.
Headbang. Now
ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the Open Air Concert Series brought to you by the Transfer Arts Foundation. We're just about to get started. One or two things before we start. If you guys would like to order a drink or tip the band, please scan the QR code that's on the back of your table sign, and one of the lovely ladies from front of house will be right out to you. Without further ado, I bring you the Short Round String Band.
Good morning, everybody. All right. Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm going to, yes, back off. Back off the mic. All right, let's get down. All right, yep.
Thank you. song. Woo! Yep. Go ahead now.
All right.
To the late, great Bill Monroe, looking at the bluegrass songs and tunes, but from maybe our old time and other time, anytime, good time perspectives, I guess, yeah. And that first one was one of his, too. And I almost remembered how to play it at the beginning. But I got back into it. It was all right. Let's do one. Who was it? Clarence Ashley did this. And also, the Dillards.
This is the first time we ever got together and decided to play music together as the four of us. This is the song that we gravitated toward, and we have a really weird video that we made of it too. If you ever go on our website, you can
we have
just,
a lot of those.
You can see how strange we actually are. We're really well behaved right now.
Yeah.
All I'll say.
The early days. Old man at the mill. Y'all there?
Yeah.
Same old man sitting at the mill. Bill turned around and don't breathe with him. Hand in the hopper and the other in the sack. Late step forward and two step back. And down flew an owl and set off quiet.
Same old man sitting at the mill. He'll turn around up his own free will.
cartoon that's got animals in it, you know, birds or other types of animals. There are other types of animals. And but I think that one's like all symbolic and stuff. It's what they call a play party song.
A play party?
That's right, guys. And which like kind of a, I think a precursor, predecessor to like barn dances and square dances and stuff. And so first to the left, and to the right, things like that. You know, lay step forward and two step back. So it's got some of those little calls in it. I'm getting all analytical here and everything, because most important things are owls and ravens, and I like those. Oh, yeah.
Bloody Mary before I could sing this song for y'all.
I'm gonna get mine afterwards for reward.
Okay. I'm walking.
Casey, don't know.
which you do know. We're the Short Round String Band. Yeah. We're pretty happy to be playing for y'all. Haven't done so in a while. Last weekend we got back on the saddle. It's been pretty fun. And we were reminded that one thing we have to do is sometimes we have to let Clark get a little bit of the glory. We try to keep it tempered, but he is going to lead us in this here fine rendition of an old Bill Monroe original tune called Old Dangerfield. We sometimes affectionately refer to this one as Old Bangerfield. And other less repeatable names. But if you could give a round of applause to Mr. Clark Wildcard Wyatt.
Hey, thank you so much. It's my distinct pleasure to introduce for you a tune, the first tune in the set that is not in the key of D. We're going A, everybody. All of our instruments are changing so much right now. And it's because they've lived in the studio in perfect climate for a year and a half, and now they're being introduced back into the wild, and they're it's not us. The instruments are just feeling a little awkward. I feel perfectly normal.
I feel like the stage
is I do too. Yeah. Let's have a tune.
Yeah, let's do it.
How about that old Bangerfield?
Yeah, here we go. Thank you.
when we play that one at 11 p.m., we don't even know our names by the end of the that tune. All right, well, so next up is one of my favorite parts of our set. This is where we play a little, pay a little homage to the wonderful John Hartford, who grew up right here in St. Louis. So we get to celebrate what he did for the St. Louis music scene, but way beyond what he did for just everyone that came after him that liked to play old-timey music. He, of course, was a great purveyor of old-timey music, and then he wrote a lot of his own stuff, and he was so appropriately weird that he gave us all license after him to be as weird as we wanted to be with the music, which is a pretty cool legacy to leave. For this one, though, we're going to have Ryan sing for you. This one's, as John Hartford often did, he sang about the river, and he sang about steamboats. So Ryan's going to sing the Steamboat Whistle Blues for you, and in case you didn't think this band was strange, Betsy and I are the strange ones. We agreed to be in a band with two banjo players, which you are about to hear right now. We like to call it harmonious twinkling. But here's Ryan and Clark with a little banjo for you.
Yeah,
uh-huh. That's amazing.
That was
cool. Kelly, we would like to publish a correction. Kelly, it's on the back page. Kelly said harmonious twinkling. It's actually harmonious tinkling.
Now it's both. But when you wear the same color shirts, it becomes twinkling.
I've heard it both ways.
Someday before I'm through, then I'll come back here, see
get out with the steamboat whistle blowing.
Making the beautiful music together. You know, there's sometimes people who don't spend a lot of time with this kind of music, whatever it is, a lot of different things. When they think about a banjo, they think it's just incessant, like rolling fast and like sharp and everything. And then I love when these guys make it all really pretty. And they're not the only ones, but they may be my favorites. I might be biased. But yeah, it's just, it's pretty lovely, and just hear like different styles of banjo playing happening together, and it just, you know, could watch those guys go by all day long, and I could watch the river roll by all day long too. Working on my segue game there. We'll do another Hartford song. How'd I do? It's not bad, right? I mean, usually I don't point it out, I just let it happen, but I'm feeling transparent today. A river tune. We got to play a John Hartford Memorial River Cruise one time a few years back, and oh, that was just so fantastic. I was daydreaming about all that, and oh, I'll just go on, but maybe we'll sing a song.
Let's sing a song.
Okay, so let's watch that river roll by. Thank you.
the river roll by.
Watching 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 the river roll by. In the evening. Oh, they do that. Watching the river go by.
Watching the river roll by.
And they didn't do it in the dead of summer either. You can figure out why. Because they didn't want to freeze or get bitten up by mosquitoes. Oh! But some nights it'd be just right. She'd come over in her bathrobe and they'd just sit there in the dark. And all they loved to do was watch the river roll by.
Watching the river roll by.
Watching the river roll by.
Watching the river roll by.
In the evening. What a fine thing.
Watching the river roll by,
watching the river roll by, in the evening. Watching the river roll by, watching the river roll by, watching the river roll by, in the evening. Watching the river roll by, watching the river go by, watching the river roll by, in the evening.
Y'all singing, playing for you. Yeah.
Thank you.
So Betsy and Clark live in Kansas City, and Ryan and I live right here in St. Louis. We call ourselves a Pan Missouri band. We do usually have a handle, though, to our pan. Our bass player lives in Lawrence, Kansas, and he could not be with us today, so we're missing him. His nickname is The Rug, because he really ties the band together. So we're missing the rug.
We're missing the rug. I mean, it is actually, I think it's his formal name.
I think it's now it's legally. It's his legally. Name. Yeah.
What's his first name?
We don't know. The. Oh, yeah. The. Exactly.
If you really want to get weird.
Oh boy.
With us.
Oh boy.
We made a special holiday time fireside chat video. Actually, the rug wasn't able to be there either. He's kind of slippery sometimes.
Yeah.
But if you look at Short Round String Band Fireside Chat on the YouTube stuff, it will keep you astounded and possibly confused for almost an hour, I think.
Oh, hopefully not that long.
Confounded and dumbfounded.
Yeah, it's got everything. It's got everything. All right.
All right. Here's an old one. This is actually a Bill Monroe song, but it's been done by an awful lot of people. This is just an old bluegrass song. Got a little cabin home. Here we go.
we're getting our microphone dance game back, and yeah. You know, and it's fun to not make any injuries in the process of doing it.
Haven't poked anybody in the eye yet.
Not yet. Well. It's early days, that's you know. There's always a chance, you know. Yeah.
That's half the fun.
Yep, yep. You know, there's Ryan's got that headband on, and it's also got padding on the inside, so when, you know, that tip of bow, it won't hurt him as bad. But you know.
My Kevlar spectacles.
Are they? Let me test them. No. You've got some bragging to do, I think.
A lot of folks over this past year ventured for the first time into the world of pet ownership. A lot of folks acquired dogs. I've always had a dog, and it's cooler than your dog. Mine's a bulldog. And I'm going to tell you all about him right now.
It's a biggin.
He weighs 500, and he barks like thunder. And I don't know if I mentioned, but he's a little cooler than your dog. It's my bulldog. And we got a little song about it.
Build my nest in that weeping willow tree where the bad boys cannot bother me. Yeah.
I don't know. We might be having just entirely too much fun on this, so let's just stop right now. Just kidding. I know, right? No, and then a riot ensued. No, it really is. It's just such a, it's a joy. It's all still like so fresh and just wonderful to get to make music with us all together again. And so here's a song that we recorded on our first. It's an EP length album, early recordings of Short Round String Man, and A Memory of Your Smile that Kelly sang earlier, that's on there too. It's a really nice collection of our first
chestnuts, I suppose, and just like with old time
music, the ones that you like, you just keep on doing forever, because good tunes, good tune, good song, just keep on doing it for your whole life, right? I've known this song for quite a long time. I learned it from a beautiful album the late Mike Seeger made. And I think it was the third annual farewell reunion. He just got together with a whole bunch of friends and did some amazing music together. This one's for the farmers out there, and for anybody else that we're wanting to think about right now.
Both literally and metaphorologically.
Exactly. And meteorologically, probably too. Thinking about farmers right now, yeah.
Only remembered for what we have done. Only remembered for
On earth here have sown. pass onward when we are forgotten. Fruit of the harvest in what we have done.
Sunday morning for a few more minutes. And we haven't sung y'all a gospel song yet, so it's about to happen. This is written by a Missourian. Alfred Brumley wrote this song.
Woo!
It goes a little something like this. Yeah.
Some Missouri roots, and then it kind of traveled around a long way, went all the way to northeast Oklahoma. And so it's one of these Ozark tunes that just has this groove that I love, and we love playing this one.
We're gonna get you some of the Missouri headphones.
Oh yeah, this the Missouri headphones is lingo when you got a guitar on either side of the fiddler, and then bonus, that's the tweeter or something.
Yeah,
tweeter.
Yeah, I got that. Yeah, that's right.
I just came up with that. I just did that. Yeah. This tune's in this rendition is called Goner. And then
Oh, I'm a goner.
You know it. Yeah, Ryan wrote some words to it. You'll hear it as well.
Betsy Ellis. She's not just an eloquent stentorian of a presentator, she's also a wonderful fiddler. We like to keep her around for that. What'd you call me?
Woo.
And now we're going to feature Miss Kelly Wells.
I'm going to sing y'all a song that was written by two people that if you know they wrote the song, you know the song's going to be awesome. And then if you're me, you have to learn to sing the song. Because this song was a co-write between Bill Monroe and Hank Williams Sr.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it gets much better than this. This one's a little bit about being blue and being lonesome. And it's an E, not B. Here we go. There we go. It's definitely good enough for the blues.
The lonesome side of a tree.
country music. Yeah. Yeah. That's one of the ones on that new album, that Bill Monroe tribute album, Ain't No Part of Nothing. And so, you know, that's something to think about. And if you're warm like us on this day and you're saying to yourself, I wish I had a bandana or even a kitchen towel because I'm like got some of the sweat coming down my face. And you're like, wouldn't that feel good to have like something to wipe all that off with? And see, right? Well, right over there, we've got some beautiful kitchen towels and bandanas and even a hanky or two that are hand crocheted by Kelly and I. And some of those bandanas are even like actual kind of vintage pieces. They're real special, and they'll take care of that sweat for you, as well as a mess in the kitchen. And so you can go check those out too afterwards. And we're gonna get Ryan Spearman back up here in the front and center. And he was bragging about a bulldog earlier. He's gonna brag about something about a gourd.
A girl and a gourd.
And so maybe there's some dancing, and there might be some partying kind of going on, parlaying and partying and everything like that. And I'm gonna switch to my cross tune fiddle so we can have the double fiddle time. You had double banjos. You thought that was like the best apex of the whole show. Well, yeah, if that's what you thought.
That's right. It's nothing better than one fiddle, except for two fiddles. This is an old-time number that didn't have enough lyrics for my liking, so I wrote some about a fiddler and a dancer falling in love for an evening.
Nice.
And you can sing along. You can catch on. Just say sugar a lot, and you'll be good to go.
Ooh, a microphone.
That wasn't supposed to happen.
I know, but I'm here now, so.
Uh-oh. Who let Clark on the mic? Yeah. What am I about to say?
Yeah, I'm thinking first. We've got one more. But also, I would just like to say thank you for joining us today in music. It feels so magical to play music in real life with people, so thank you.
That's why we call him the wild card. You never know what he's going to say on the mic. Sometimes it's sweet. Sometimes it's not FCC approved.
It does, yeah. Well, yeah. Yeah, well, we had fun with the sugar in the gourd. Now we got to go beat up Satan.
Let's do it.
Because that's what you do.
Thank you again. This is our last one, so
yeah,
thank you for
it.
It's called Chased Old Satan Through the Door.
Well, I chased old Satan down the lane, and I hit him in the head with a walking cane. I'm gonna wear that starry crown over there. Shortening bread, and I'm gonna wear that starry crown over there. Over there. Well, I run old Satan up the stump, and I give him a kick with every jump, and I'm gonna wear that starry crown over there, over there, over there. I'm gonna wear that starry crown over there. For I got no skillet and I got no lid, and ash cake tastes like shortening bread, and I'm gonna wear that starry crown over there.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, give it up for the Short Round String Band. On behalf of the Kranzberg Arts Foundation, I'd like to thank you all once again for coming out this very warm and muggy Sunday morning. Now, we encourage you to go ahead and finish your drinks, enjoy each other's company. However, we do have another show coming up after this, so if you could make your way towards the exit in the next 15 minutes or so, we would greatly appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Like we all broke free.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Open Air Concert Series on behalf of the Kranzberg Arts Foundation. One thing real quick before we get started, because it is brunch and drinks are always important, if you guys would like to order anything, please scan the QR code on the back of your table, and one of the food and beverage staff will be out to help you as soon as they can. Other than that, sit back and relax and enjoy. I forgot what you're called again, sorry. Short Brown String Band. Literally just looked at the table and couldn't remember.
Thank you.
well behaved in the first set that we did today. I'm not sure what's going to happen in this set, because we played that a lot faster than we did at 11 a.m. So we're glad that y'all are here to join us and experience whatever happens with the Short Round String Band on stage today. All right. We're going to sing y'all a song that Bill Monroe wrote. This one is a cautionary tale. There we go.
Some other numbers from that album in the set, but we're going to go way back now. We're going to do one. It's apparently about an old man at the mill, but really it's about birds. And then
it's always about birds.
For me, it is. It's always about birds. You'll find out more about that. But if you listen real close and you like the history of like the square dances and stuff, you might hear some of the calls, as you will. And you don't have to do them, so I'm not telling you to move to the left or the right.
You could.
It's up to you, but you could if you wanted to. Same old man sitting at the mill.
Well, actually, I'd like to tell a story.
No. Oh, no.
You said something about not being as well behaved this set, so oh my gosh, I just gear jammed this. So this song is one of the very first things that us as a band ever recorded, and we made a really zany video of this song. It comes from the Dillards, and we're all huge fans of the Dillards. The Dillards?
The Dillards!
So the Dillards were from Salem, Missouri, and thereabouts, and the Dillard Mill is about, 10, 15, maybe 20 miles as the crow flies from Salem, Missouri, so we figured Dillard Mill had something to do with the Dillards. And so we went there to make this video of this song. And while we were setting up cameras and microphones in front of this little cabin, a park ranger rolled by and we said, "We're at Dillard Mill doing a Dillard song." And she was like, "Yeah, there's no association with the Dillards whatsoever." And I said, "We're gonna pretend like we didn't hear that."
Yeah. it always will be linked in our minds, in our hearts. Well, that's a little funky, but it's there. That's pretty good. Two, three.
Same old man sitting at the mill. Mill turned around of his own free will. Hand in the hopper and the other in the sack. Lady step forward and two step back.
Now I'm blue now and he said all quiet. A lonesome day and a lonesome night. Thought I heard a pretty girl say, you court all night and you sleep next day. Weekend and we're just going to keep doing that through the month of May. That's right, Peaceful Bend. And yeah, and next week for Memorial Day weekend, we'll be right back down there too at the Merrimack Spring Park, and going to do a concert series. They're kicking off a new concert series, and we get to do that. So after not being together for like a year and a half, three weekends in a row is pretty darn dreamy. We're going to do one of our earlier Chestnut hits. It's on our early recordings of Sugar and String Band EP. Kelly Wells is gonna do that heartbreaking thing, aren't you?
Here we go now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, it happens every once in a while. We do actually allow Clark on the mic. Usually he just sneaks his way up there unofficially, but on this here tune, we're going to actually feature Mr. Clark Wildcard Wyatt here on the banjo. Give him a round of applause. And he's going to play an old fiddle tune written by Mr. Bill Monroe. We put out an album recently called Ain't No Part of Nothing, and it's a bit of an old-time tribute to Bill Monroe. And this is on that album, and as I mentioned, it's featuring the wild card here. And we have a good old time with this. I hope you enjoy it. We also call this Old Banjo Field, and we call it other things that we can't repeat on stage.
All right, here we go. No, I'm gonna wild card, and I'm not gonna say a word.
All right. Oh.
Too. So Bill Monroe meets Ralph Stanley and takes it back on home again. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
You know, that was a good banjo feature.
It was.
We should feature another one.
Have you had enough banjo though?
Oh, well,
no?
Never.
Oh,
right?
Okay.
I mean, you and I decided to be in a band with a couple of these, like,
not just one banjo is in our band. Oh, no.
No, you just can't have it. That's not enough.
It's not enough.
We're like, not only in a band with them, we're like linked up with them for life.
Forever.
What were we thinking? It's a good thing we like banjo, and you will too. If you're on the banjo fence, as it were, people, if you're like, I'm not sure if banjo's for me. You know, when I think banjo, I think about all those jokes and the canoes and all that kind of stuff, and it's like, okay, it can be scary. I admit, The banjo can be a scary instrument. You just never know what you're getting into if you go into a jam and then there's somebody there with a banjo, let alone if there's more than somebody there with a banjo. This song is gonna change your mind if you didn't need it changing already. Wait, change it if you want or don't, but you're gonna love it, I'll tell you that much. Because when these two guys play on this song and some of the other ones where there is the natural phenomenon known affectionately in our band as harmonious tinkling, it's the sound of their two banjos meeting together in bliss. Well, it will calm the wildest of beasts within you, and it will put you into a very happy place, and I feel like you're already kind of there with him. You know, Ryan's going to sing this beautiful John Hartford song, and we got the harmonious tinkling machine ready to go.
A little Steamboat Whistle Blues. In the Illinois trade with the coal dust in my ear. Got stuck in the ice on Christmas Eve and it froze my ass, it's true. Shivering and shaking with the down south case of them steamboat whistles. Oh, Captain Way, I'm sorry, my hat's off to you. Been hanging out by the old cook stove with the steamboat whistle blues. What?
Something about some press, and it just, you know, I just sit there, and if I wouldn't listen to Kelly sing all day, I'd listen to Ryan sing all day too. And well, you're lucky when you get to hear it together too. And I do listen to Clark playing any kind of many different instruments all day too. And we're back home over on the other coast of Missouri over there in Kansas City. Let's do another Hartford song though. How about this and another water themed song? It may not be as poignant as Ryan's, but
this one's pretty fresh.
It's got some points to it. Yeah, some angles and some curves. And
I just want to say thank you, Betsy. About a year ago, when a bunch of drums started showing up in our house.
She still agreed to marry you?
Thank you. Yeah, exactly. She still loves me.
Well, we had already all the banjos that we could hold, so we had to go to something. All right. All right. Or get bitten up by mosquitoes. But some nights it'd be just right. She'd come over to her bathrobe and they'd just sit there in the dark on that porch. And all they did was watch the river roll by.
Watching the river roll by.
Watching the river roll by. Watching
the river roll by.
Watching the river roll by. In the evening, I said it's a good thing to do. Oh, watching the river roll by.
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 Here for our last set, he recognized her from like 10 years ago in a
like
North Carolina show.
Ago, 20 years ago.
That's the kind of indelible mark that Betsy Ellis will leave on your fragile psyche if you're not careful.
Could be a stain, folks.
Ryan and Betsy met in the back alley of a Kansas City bar over 20 years ago, and here we all are today.
True story.
That is a true story, but there's a lot more to it, but it sounds more fun to just leave it there.
It does. I like
all right,
that.
All right.
It's intriguing.
All right, we're gonna sing y'all just a sweet little number about a little cabin home.
Sit alone and cry in our
Kelly Wells singing that. Clark Wyatt and Ryan Spearman, they don't only tinkle harmoniously, they... Wait a minute.
That's enough of that.
That's only when camping. So, well, we said that we were really sweet and you know, and very sweet our last set. And it's the second set, you know how it goes. And y'all are in on it, so it's fine. But anyway, it sounds really good when they do their pick style, like Fred, those other types of instruments, you know, that stuff together. We had a really cool experience one time in Kansas City a few years back as part of like kind of a citywide art show. There was a gentleman from Brooklyn who came with a portable recording studio, and he would make records on the spot. And like, there's only two in the world that exist, and he has one, and we have the other. And we made a recording of a little cabin home on the hill, and one other one. What was it? Memory versus no.
Satan.
Oh, it was. Oh, we'll get to that. Don't worry, we'll get to Satan. All right. But in the meantime, I know, right? The intrigue builds. In the meantime, Ryan. What, you know, you talk about this thing you got, and I don't know if I believe you.
Yeah, you know, during this past year, a lot of people acquired pets. That's something that happened. I already had one, and mine's cooler than yours. Mine's a bulldog, and it's really big, and
so
it barks like thunder.
So you said.
I'm going to sing you a little song about it. Yeah, it weighs about 500.
Yeah, sure.
My backyard.
all by myself.
No,
I can't stay here by myself.
No,
I can't stay here apparently with anybody else. But I know I can't stay here by myself. Ever, I'm as free little bird as I can be. Free little bird as I can be.
Things out, but that's not what this is about. This is about honoring those who've who've left us, and just keep them in mind and remember them. This is a beautiful old song that's kind of sort of on the spiritual nature, but not like strongly so. It's, you know, it's just got a lot of good sentiment and something we can all relate to in this. It's called Only Remembered. It was written in the 19th century. Goes back a little ways.
Bit of an existential.
It is kind of a bit of an existential exploration and general questioning, but also, yeah, honoring. Called Only Remembered. But you'll hear that a lot of times, so you probably figure out that was the title even if I didn't say it. Only remembered, only remembered, only remembered for what we have done. Only remembered, only remembered, only remembered for what we have done. Morning, soaring from earth to its home near the sun. Thus would I pass from the earth and its toiling, only remembered for what I have done. Only remembered, only remembered, only remembered for what.
We have done.
Well, it's Sunday, and we have yet to sing you a gospel song. So we're going to do that now, and we're going to sing you a gospel song written by a Missourian. Alfred Brumley wrote this one. It's a little song about...
Brumley, yes.
Yes, it's a little song about turning on your radio. Come and listen in to the Glory Land Station. Hear the mighty glad Hosannas roll. Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Get a little taste of love eternal. Get a little heaven in your soul. Get in touch with God.
Get in touch with God.
Turn your radio on.
The beautiful state of Missouri and a star on both coasts. Oh, well, is that, do you got the Missouri on yours? Oh, monogram. Well, that's almost as cool. No, that's really cool. You've got yours, but not everybody might have one. And you just go over there and you can take a look after we're done. We got things like those things that keep the sweat off your brow as we get into this hot summertime that we're getting into. And recordings, free stickers. And a comic book that will take you on an incredible adventure with the Short Round String Band. We might have, by the time we were at a certain point in that story in the comic book, we might have been goners. See what I did there? It's a segue. Yeah, that's the name of the tune, Goner.
Thank you.
on the fiddle, folks.
Yeah!
Gonna feature Miss Kelly here on some vocal rendition of an old classic country bluesy number for you. And those of you who aren't here, well, I guess none of you are here for the first set. I'll let you know that we did similar stuff, but we played more precisely but with less spirit. So I think y'all are getting the better end of the bargain, because around here we have a motto: attitude before aptitude.
Well, before I sing this, another person that needs some recognition is Danny the Sound Man. He's done an awesome job helping us out today. We sang him a little part of Oh Danny Boy, don't worry, we did our duty. But I'm gonna sing y'all this song. This is a song that was written by two gentlemen whose names you will recognize. And it was one of those things where when I realized that they had co-written this song, I had no choice but to learn to sing it and play it. This one was written by Bill Monroe and Hank Williams Sr. This one's called I'm Blue and Lonesome.
It's on the Ain't No Part of Nothing recording. We have time for a couple more for you this afternoon. And thanks to the Grandel, am I saying it right?
Grandel.
Thanks to the Big G for putting on this concert series and inviting us to be a part of it. And Kelly,
yeah.
Thank Danny. We thank him and the nice folks from Dark Room here who've made us all feel so hospitable and welcome here. And we thank y'all for your efforts. and your kindness and you all sharing this time with us here, it just means the world. It's just great to be back and play together, and so we're celebrating it together, and we hope we see you again real soon. We are going to do a little extreme kind of thing for the last couple of songs. The first one's a total party song. Yay! And then there'll be Satan.
Yeah.
First we party, then we kick up, we kick Satan's butt after at the end. That's how it. Two fiddles for sugar in the gourd for the party. Or you bet you're right. Double fiddle. Obviously, you know your stuff. We should. We've been doing it wrong all along.
No, that's how we summon.
Oh, that's how we summon.
They summon Satan with two fiddles. That's the exactly devil's the devil's box right here. Two of them. It's the second fiddle.
I'm gonna play second fiddle to rhyme.
All right, we have a good time around here, folks. This is an old fiddle tune called Sugar in the Gourd. There's only a couple lines to this tune that I could ever find, so I kind of wrote some more. It's about a fiddler and a dancer falling in love for an evening. There's a chorus if you want to sing along. It goes, sugar in the gourd, can't get it out. The way to get sugar is to roll it on about. Sugar in the gourd, sugar in the gourd, sugar in the gourd, sugar in the gourd.
So, did you get that? Yeah. Did you get that?
And any variant you want to throw in there is fine as well. And it goes a little something like this.
Any variant. I'm so excited. Yeah!
for joining us in our fun today, and we appreciate y'all being a part of this experience for us, because we're really excited to all be back playing music, and it doesn't work.
It's our new catchphrase for short round shows. Yay! And y'all brought it here today. Yep, somebody was looking for Satan. We're gonna kick him.
Here we go.
We're gonna chase old Satan through the door. One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, give it up for the Short Round String Band. I had to grab a CD to make sure I got their name right this time. Now, thank you all so very much for coming out this very, very warm and muggy Sunday afternoon. On behalf of the Kranzberg Arts Foundation, I'd like to thank each and every one of you for coming out. That being said, it is officially closing time. I don't want to rush you out. You have plenty of time to finish your drinks, finish your food. However, if in the next 15 minutes or so you can make your way towards the exit, we would greatly appreciate it, because it takes a very long time to shut down the tent. One more time, thank you guys very much for coming out.
Thank you.